Join us as we travel through the Great Lakes. First stop is Ludington, Michigan. It took us about 8 hours to get up to Ludington, Michigan, but we had to go through the states of Pennsylvania, Ohio, and Michigan. Our first stop here in Ludington, Michigan was at the House of Flavors, an ice cream store that you won't ever forget. And also the food is unbelievable. So please look into that one if you're in this area. So I decided to walk out to the Ludington Breakwater Lighthouse. Out through the breakwater that is over a half mile from the entrance. So you can see that I've speeded up the film for this excursion. This was perfect timing because it's 7 o'clock in the evening and the SS Badger is coming into port. The SS Badger is a car ferry that goes to Wisconsin. We'll be on that tomorrow. Taking the SS Badger from Ludington, Michigan to Manitowoc, Wisconsin. Here we are getting the board, the SS Badger, a National Historical Landmark. The SS Badger is the last coal-fired passenger steamship in operation in the United States.
Thank you.
It's going to take almost 4 hours to make it across Lake Michigan to Manitowoc, Wisconsin. On the SS Badger, there is a lot of things to do. They have Badger Bingo, the shop and the gift shop, and there's staterooms for anyone who wants to stay, and also free movies in the movie lounge. Thank you.
Join us as we're heading up through Green Bay in the Upper Peninsula of Michigan. On September 6, 1962, the Soviet satellite Sputnik crashed on this site in Manitowoc, Wisconsin. It would take us approximately 4 hours to make it up to Escobar, Michigan. We pulled into Steve's Cheese in Denmark, Wisconsin, but found out that it was closed on Sundays. We stopped in Green Bay, Wisconsin at Lambeau Field, home of the Green Bay Packers. We stopped at Chernobyl's restaurant in Menominee, Michigan. However, it was closed at this time on Sunday, but there's a nice park in the back, right next to Lake Michigan.
Join us as we continue our travels through the Upper Peninsula of Michigan, all the way up to Muncie, Michigan. Here's the route we're going to be taking. It's going to take us approximately 2 hours to get up there. Trenary Bakery was actually closed on Monday when we were there. However, you can actually see it on the Travel Channel's Bizarre Foods Delicious Destinations. I finally reached Lake Superior, an all-terrain beach in all-terrain Michigan. We reached the town of Christmas, Michigan. Thank you.
On this episode, we'll be taking the Pitcher Rock Cruises. Thank you. As we were waiting to board our boat, the fog just kept getting thicker and thicker and rolled in. When it became apparent we weren't going to be able to see the shore, the captain announced that he has canceled the trip and would be refunding our money at the end of the trip. So we headed back to shore. As we returned back to port, the fog cleared.
Thank you.
On this episode, we'll be continuing our journey through the Upper Peninsula of Michigan. Our journey is going to take about 4 hours. If you're up in the UP, you've got to go to Palms Book State Park in the Big Springs, which is Itch Itty Kippy. We had lunch at Clyde's Drive-In, a drive-in from the 1950s. The food was just absolutely amazing.
above the seats on the main deck and behind the pilot house on the upper deck. Thank you.
Thank you.
way.
On this episode, we'll be driving down to Frankenmuth, Michigan, where we will stop at Bonner's Christmas Store. It's going to take approximately 4 hours to be able to get down to Frankenmuth, Michigan. We stopped at the Cross in the Woods in Indian River, Michigan. Our first stop in Frankenmuth was at Zender's restaurant. Thank you. On the right is Bonner's Christmas Wonderland. As you can see, the lights are on all year round. Here we are entering the parking lot of Bonner's Christmas Wonderland in Frankfort, Michigan. Here is Silent Night Memorial Chapel. It's located on Bonner's Christmas Wonderland. Bonner's Christmas Wonderland is the largest Christmas store in the world. On this episode, we'll be going to Tony's I-75 restaurant, and we'll be going to Point Clinton, Ohio. Tony's, which is located in Birch Run, Michigan. Tony's is famous for their 1-pound BLT.
Okay, guys.
We are at Tony's on I-75 in Birch Run, Michigan.
Bigger than a piece of cheese.
It's
supposed to have cheese.
It's going to take us approximately 6 hours to be able to get back to Pittsburgh.
about.